And now we'd like to welcome Tim Crawley from the Rochester Museum and Science Center.
Hey guys, good to see you again.
What do you got for us today?
Well, today what we're going to do is Mastodon toothpaste.
All right.
And Mastodon some people call it elephant toothpaste. And then there's those that are very particular that will call it the catalytic decomposition of hydrogen peroxide.
That sounds smart.
Well, it sounds good till you try to say it fast three times.
Okay.
Since you have a mastodon, I see that's why you're calling it Mastodon's toothpaste.
Exactly.
So okay. Cool.
Very cool mastodon skeleton.
We got to give him his props.
Yeah.
And actually, when you think of hydrogen peroxide, you think of that brown bottle that's in your medicine cabinet, foams up when it hits a cut or whatever. Mm-hmm. And that's the same stuff as this, only this is 30%. The stuff that you have in the medicine cabinet, that's about 3%. This is the stuff that your grandmother, great-grandmother used to make her hair yellow and her scalp pink. It's a little caustic, but it's all right. It's not terrible. But what it is, it's H2O2. Okay. That's the chemical makeup.
Okay.
So when it breaks down, if you look at it that way, you think, what can you make out of H2O2? And you go H2O, so there's a water, and that leaves an oxygen floating out there.
Okay.
So if you got a couple of them, there's a couple of things of water, and there's O2, which is oxygen, which is air, and it's a gas.
Part of the air, anyway.
Part of the air, yeah.
One of the
part of the air. So when it does break down, it breaks down into water and oxygen.
Okay.
Which is cool for this demonstration, because what we're also going to do is we're going to add a little soap to it. Mm-hmm. So when we add a little soap to it.
I see this plastic down here.
Yeah. But that's because there's this whole liability insurance thing that we've got.
Okay, cool.
So they said, you know, if we could put some plastic down case. And when you see me start to run.
That's our cue to run.
That's our cue. We'll pick up on it. But what we're going to do is if you take soap, water, and air, and you put it together, what do you get?
We're going to get some bubbles.
Bubbles. So that's what we're going to do. So to prep it, we'll put good amount of soap in there, because you know, you never know.
All right.
I'm going to put my goggles on, just because.
We'll step back with a
safety first, last, and always. Actually, Joe, I think I'm going to give you the goggles at the end. It's your last show. We'll let you do it. And let's see it. It's Joe's last show. So we'll just
that much good, a little more be better.
Oh, there's only that much left in there, Joe.
All right.
What are you going to do with that? There you go.
All right.
That'll work out fine. Don't worry about that, folks. And, our catalyst is potassium iodide.
Catalyst is for what? What is that?
A catalyst. That's a great question. It's like, think of the word cattle prod. Okay. If you use a cattle prod, what does it make a cow do?
I mean, they're going to move faster.
It makes them move faster. Okay. Catalyst makes a chemical reaction happen faster.
Cool. Mm-hmm.
And actually, when it does, if you take your hands, put it together, and start real slow to move them, that's your chemical reaction. Going pretty slow now. Speed it up.
It's getting warm.
You start to feel heat. That's a byproduct of this. It's going to be.
This
it's
is an exotherm.
Exactly. Okay. I jumped ahead. Exothermic reaction, and this should work pretty well. The potassium iodide. The cool part is too. When you watch it at the end, you'll see a little of that yellow or brown on the outside, and that's going to be the iodide.
Okay. Right.
So now we've got enough in there to get going. And the big thing with this to make it work really well, as I've been working with it a lot over the years trying to get, because you see it sometimes people do it where it just shoots up 5, 8, 10 feet in the air and it gets all over. But it's surface area. Okay. You want to get as much of this hitting, as much surface area at one time.
Okay.
And then when it builds the reaction up, it'll throw it all out. So what I'm going to do is pour.
All right.
I'm gonna let Tim do it. He's dressed for it. I don't want to.
No. All right. Okay.
All right. We're gonna step back
I'm gonna
a moment.
Do,
I'm a bit here.
Thank you, Tim.
Let's find out. See if it works or not. Now this is, it's all theory. So let's find out. In 3, 2, 1.
Whoa! Cool.
And there's the toothpaste part.
Oh wow.
It's almost like we knew what we were doing.
Yeah.
And now, you can see what's coming off of it, the steam. Now, the reason why I've got the little dowel that I start up is I like to see if I can get this to glow just a little bit.
All right.
And see if we can't, see if we can get it from.
Oh, I'm not surprised.
May have broke down too fast. No, there it goes.
There you go.
A little bit. There we are.
Yeah.
And the reason why it goes from just a glowing ember to a little bit of a, let's see if we can get it to do it in the bottle. Although the bottle, it pumped out everything. That was pretty well done.
Cool.
And that's the oxygen inside of those air bubbles. You got to go deep down into it because the reaction was so fast it actually broke the cells to the...
There we go.
Small shiny objects.
Yep, they can't see it, so.
Well, they can't, but I can.
That was great.
It gets down to
So what else can you tell us about this?
It's a great demo.
Yep.
And you can see the yellow.
The color. Yeah, that's, all the yellow in there. Yeah.
That's the iodine that comes from the potassium iodide.
Okay.
And it's a great demonstration. And right now it should be pretty safe to touch.
And, you know, we can talk quickly about hydrogen peroxide. That's naturally in your body. Your body's always breaking it down. You have an enzyme catalase that does that. So this does a much cooler way, but that's a great demo that we talk about.
That's why, is that why you get the bubbles on your finger when you put the hydrogen peroxide on it?
We see the reaction. So it's the bubbles. So we want to thank Tim for being here tonight. But to learn more about the Rochester Museum and Science Center, head to our website, homeworkhotline.org, and stay right there. We'll be back in just a second.
Thanks, Tim.
Thanks, Joe.